गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स, सो वी आर नाउ गोइंग फॉर द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर. इट्स ए क्रिटिकल चैप्टर. लिसन टू दिस कन्वर्सेशन वेरी केयरफुली. द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज द मिडनाइट विजिटर. दिस चैप्टर हैज मेनी इंट्रिकेसीज डिटेल. आई विल गिव यू ईच एंड एवरी इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट दिस चैप्टर. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. The main characters of this chapter, the Midnight Visitor, is Ossible. Who is Ossible? He is a spy agent who do espionage. ESPIONAGE. Espionage means, like I am a spy. Suppose I am spy. I am sent by, I have to go to Pakistan secretly and mingle with their people without telling them I am an Indian spy and get information about their nuclear missiles, their technology, and pass it back to my country India. That is called as spy. And when I will enter Pakistan, take all their details, it will be termed as espionage, which is a crime. Indian Secret Service is known as RAW, which means Research Analysis Wing. Pakistan Secret Service is known as ISI, Intelligence Service in Asia. So this is about spy. Ossible is a spy agent. Second very important character is Fowler. Fowler is an entertaining kind of a person. He is a young writer who is looking for an interesting story. Third character is Max. Max is another spy who wants to steal a secret paper from Ossible, which has all the details of the missile technology. And the fourth character is the Henry, which is mentioned some at the end of the chapter. These are the four characters: Ossible, Fowler, third Max, fourth Henry. Always remember that. Now, how the story unfolded? Ossible is a fat man. He is a ugly looking man, does not look smart. And Fall is greatly disappointed to know that he is going to interview, quiz a person who is not at all smart or interesting. He lives in Paris. And in Paris, he lives in a French hotel. In the French hotel on the 6th, which is the topmost floor, there he lives. And where they are going to meet, that room is very cramped. It has a little space. So it does not sound very interesting. And Fowler is a very young, energetic, dynamic kind of a person, full of enthusiasm, grit and determination. He is searching for a new story. So Ossible spoke French and German with an American accent. Why? Because originally he is an American. He brought his American accent to Paris 12 years ago. And now what further happens, that when Fowler meets Ossible, Ossible tells that, my dear friend, you are let down. You are feeling disillusioned. You are feeling disappointed that this kind of spy I am, who is fat, who is ugly, who does not have that, you know, charismatic cap, the gun, or the smart look, or the goggles like a spy. You are disappointed and you have to wait at the French ballroom with an ugly fat guy who is staring down the beauties. So Ossible chuckled means like this, and he whizzed means breathing noisily. It is called as whizzed. So he opened the door and called Ossible, please come inside. So Ossible came and he says, my dear friend, you envisioned, it is written in the chapter, envision means to see, that I must be carrying guns, there must be girls, and hold the scenario like a James Bond movie. No, it is not like that. So Then after that, Ossible says, wait, you will not be disappointed because I have a piece of paper. That paper is very integral and important and critical. Many men and women will risk their life to get that paper. That piece of paper has such important knowledge. As soon as Ossible, when Fowler entered the room and Ossible was going to close the room and on the light, he saw, Fowler saw a man holding a pistol. And all of a sudden, Ossible was aghast, frightened. He said, Max, it's you? Now, who is Max? Max is a slender. Slender means thin. He is a slender looking person who is small than 6 feet. And his features show that he has a countenance of a fox. Fox is always wily, very clever. So the Max was holding the pistol. So Ossible says, I thought you were in Berlin. How you came to my room? So Max says, oh ho ho ho, I came here for that piece of paper. That piece of paper is very critical and important. Because remember student, Ossible was having a very important piece of paper. And that piece of paper was very critical and important. And Max is the other spy. He wanted to steal that paper from him. He was telling, give me that piece of paper. It will be safer with me rather than you. Ossible says, really? It is the truth? He says, okay. Now, Ossible look at Fa and say, damn, this balcony. Now, this is the second time. Always listen to this part very carefully, my dear students. You have to top in the district Yamunanagar in English. This is the... There is a balcony. Ossible is telling to Fowler. And the Fowler is telling, balcony? Kehta, yes. And this is the second time he intruder has come through the balcony and entered my room. Earlier, someone also did that. And I told my management. Management means the bosses. To close that room or to close that balcony. Now he's explaining about the balcony. He is telling my, this room is the part of a very big unit. This is my room. This is my room. Close to this room is the balcony. And close to that is the living room and the two rooms. And someone can easily cross those two rooms, living room, and can easily enter my balcony. And this what the first person did. And Max then immediately said, oh, I should have known about that balcony. It should have saved me from certain mess because I entered your room with great difficulty. Now, Max told Fall, sit down. No need to hurry. We have been waiting for 30 minutes. So, Ossible intervened and said, no, not 30, 31 minutes. So, Ossible asked that our meeting was at 12:30. Now, see the exchange of words. Exchange of words were done by Ossible to fool Max. Now, Max telling, I wonder how such important paper reached your people. But he says, anyways, there is no loss. I came at time, give me that paper. And I need it. Then at that very moment, somebody knocked like this. And then Ossible told, that when the first robbery happened, when the first man entered my room, I told the policeman to come and inquire about my room because I am holding such an important paper. So it might be policeman. Now, all of a sudden, Max was frightened. He was flummoxed and he told, oh, so he told, if I will not answer, anyways, the police will come. Why? Because the door is unlocked. So what should I do? So Max holds the gun like this. And he pointed so that the gun is pointed towards Fowler and Ossible. He put his one leg outside the window. And he says, give me the paper or anyways the police will enter or I will shoot you. So the knobbing goes louder and say, Mr. Ossible. Then putting like this, Max, his one leg is outside the window and he's doing like this. His one leg is outside the window and he's doing like this. And he put his second leg also outside the window. Then he was holding with the left hand and he dropped the left hand and he went down. And there was a huge shriek. Ah! Now, there was a knock on a door. Mr. Ossible, the waiter, came in. He has a wine bottle with two glasses. That wine bottle was uncorked open and this. And Fowler was aghast. He was telling, what happened to that man Max? Where he is? Kata, don't worry, he will not come back. He said, why? Kata, because there was no balcony. It was just a sixth floor, there was no balcony. I created that story. He said, what? Kata, yeah, he is dead. And that man who is knocking, Kata, he is none other than my friend Henry. So this is an interesting story, my dear students. I hope you understood it. If you have any doubt, any question, any query regarding this chapter, please tell me also. This is the important points you can note. Thank you very much. God bless you.